Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime 92, and today I'm going to be starting a new Let's Build. I know it's been a while, but I decided I should really do one, because I did enjoy doing them. Now, this is on the super deformed Tensyouryu Koumei Nu-Gundam from the Son Gokuden line. And I probably totally butchered that name, but it'll be in the top, so you'll know what it is. The box art is really, really nice. I've always liked the Son Gokuden box art. Very nicely detailed. And you have the Bandai logo here. This logo here, which I'm not really exactly sure what it is, but a lot of the newer kits have it. Even ones that aren't really from the Son Gokuden line. And then over here you have the different modes. It's got so many different versions. So it already is, I think, worth it. It's about $10 to $11 because it is a bigger box and a bigger kit, so it's a little more expensive than the normal ones. Over here, it is the 27th in the Son Gokuden line, and it is the 330th in the Super Deform line. And then you have its faction there. And then over here, you have more pictures of its forms, and then this is just the same as the other end. And over here on the bottom, you even have a picture of the new Gundam, which looks like this is what it would be in the actual series that's on in Japan. So that is the actual box, but I'm going to be doing a dual build, and the other one is going to be on the exact same kit, pretty much, except it is the Jargon brand. I've only seen this one in the Jargon knockoff brand. I've never seen it before or since ever. I don't even think I've heard of this brand. And I saw it at Walter Hobby Store for $5.50. I already had the Bandai version, but I wanted this one just to see what it's like, because I've never heard of it ever, and I probably never will. And it's not even in the Walter Hobby Store anymore. That I don't think it is. And it's basically the same box art. No logo there. Just the Jargon up there. And you got the same pictures on the side. I'd love to know what 932 represents, because I doubt they've made that many knockoffs. And then you got same thing on this side, just I'm assuming it's all Chinese. And same on that side. So that's really about it. The cardboard is cheaper feeling than the Bandai, but it holds together a lot better than, say, the TT Hongli boxes. I find they fall apart very easily. The adhesive is very weak. Now, I'm going to show you a side-by-side so you can get a good look at the two together. And you'll be able to see they're basically the exact same size, just with the different text and logos. So that's what they look like as for boxes, but let's go and see what they look like inside. Alright, so here are the instructions, and I just want to make sure you guys know that the Bandai brand will always be on the left, and the Jargon will be on the right, so you'll know which is which. And so far, they look identical. Pretty much the same quality, but if you notice, the Jargon has this black border around it. And it's actually a little bigger because of that. I don't know why. It doesn't add anything. If you look at here in the instruction part, it doesn't actually add anything. Just gives it a black border. I don't get it. And of course you have Chinese here, Japanese here, I assume. And you've also have this one, the Jargon one. Unlike all the TT Hongli kits I have, there is no English that I can find in the instructions. Where in the TT Hongli there is some kind of English, so it's like, you can't really get, it's not proper English, but you do get the basic idea of what they're trying to tell you. This does not have that, so it's all in, I guess, Chinese. So that's the instructions. About the same. Now, on to the stickers. Once again, left is Bandai, right is Jargon, and basically, they're pretty much the same. Some of the things, pretty much the vents on the Jargon are a little offset. The eyes look pretty good, although all the silver is more of this speckly effect on the Jargon, where the Bandai is nice and crisp. However, the Jargon, the blue is all metallic, where the Bandai is all plain flat blue, and I really like the metallic. I don't know how it's going to look on the kit, but I do like it. So that's kind of interesting. And then back here you see it's more of a lighter yellow compared to the Jargon. So those are the stickers. Pretty close, but who knows what they're like to actually apply. We'll see. Now we come to the trees, and I'm going to start with the A plate. And this is the Bandai, and this is the Jargon. And right off the bat you can see the Bandai one, you've got white, red, blue, and dark gray all on the one plate, while on the Jargon, you've got three separate ones. One white, one gray, one blue. No red. Where are the red parts? Right here, on the blue plate, which is weird. So now you're already missing a color in the knockoff. So not really the best. I mean, you could, it's only like two, three pieces right here, but it's still kind of annoying. So let's see how the other plates fare. Alright, here is the B plate. Now, this is the Bandai, and as you can see, it's one solid piece. Where this one, I actually have to show you two new ones and the one I showed last time, because the parts are actually split up. They've rearranged all the parts, pretty much. Because these, some of these are from the A plate originally, and some of these are as well. But these parts on the shoulder, you can see, are over here. So they've really, really meddled things around. It's kind of weird. I don't know why they just didn't keep them the same, especially with the white, but they didn't, so it looks a lot more here than what's here. But it really isn't. So let's look at the C plate. And here's the C plate, the frosty yellow, you've got the Bandai is one, and for some reason they felt the need to make the Jargon one two, and I don't get it, because it's just one solid piece. I don't see a need to separate them and make them completely different. Like, this is the sword and the dragon head are together. They're on complete separate sides of the Bandai one. I just don't really understand why. Why go through all the trouble of doing that and completely swapping them all around and not just copying them exactly. So it's really weird. It's interesting, that's for sure. Okay, so the D plate is probably the closest one we have in terms of how they look on the actual trees here. And they still decided to change them around. Ignore this piece, it came off. The super deformed kits are designed to, or at least the newer ones are designed to just pop them off the trees without having to worry about the snippers. Sometimes they fall out in the package. But they've totally rearranged them once again in completely different sizes. I don't know why. They're all here, but they're just different. I don't really understand why, but okay, whatever. And finally, we have the polycaps. And surprisingly, these are the only parts that were kept the same. Pretty much exact. The little end pieces are different. That one doesn't have any up here, but they are pretty much this way they're supposed to be. So yeah. The polycaps are pretty much identical in placement. So that's about it for the first part. Probably got on longer than I want. I'll probably cut it up to make it a little more seamless. But yeah, those are all the parts we're going to work with, and tune in for part two where I actually start to build it.